Hey guys, welcome back in CodeSphere. So today in this series, this is a fresh new series of creating Android app for user registration with email authentication using Firebase. So as you can see on the screen that this is our login UI, and now we cannot log in because we have not created the account. So for this, you have to simply set up an account. So click on sign up, and now you can see that this is our user create account activity. So here I have to give any demo email, so I can give any email, but make sure it is email, and then after this I will give password, and it should be at least 6 words. So now as you can see that when I will check this box, check show password, so now you can see the password, and when I will click on the button register, and you can see this is a progress bar is in progress, and now we successfully logged in our Android app. So if I will click on this button sign out, so now we came back to login UI, and now we can sign in because we have already created account. So here I have to again write this email, and after this I will write password, and when I will again check this box, so now I can see the password, and if I will write wrong password, so I cannot log in because you can see that there will be an error. Yes, error, the password is invalid or the user does not have a password. So I have to give correct password, and after giving correct password, when I will click on this button login, so I will be able to log in our Android app. So you can see that it is in progress, and yes guys, we successfully logged in. So in this series I will show you how you can do this in your Android app. So without wasting time, let's start. In this video we will only create UI of login UI, register UI, and main activity. So you can see that this is our main activity.java, and this is main activity underscore XML file. So here I'm simply using a button for sign out. So you can see that this is our button, and ID is sign out. So I will need it later for logout. So after this, what we have to do is we will simply create another activity for login. So simply click right and then go to new, and then choose an MPT activity. Yeah, MPT activity. And we will give it name login, simply because this is our login activity, and then click on finish. So now our activity is creating, and yeah, it's in progress. So guys, now you can see that it is created successfully. So after this, what we have to do is we will simply change its parent layout to linear layout. Now it is constant layout. So let me change it to linear layout. Yeah guys, then after this I will give it gravity, and it will be center, then orientation, it will also vertical. Yes, so after this we have to create a background file, I mean a drawable file for background. So simply go to drawable and then new, and then drawable resource file, and we will give it name background because it will be in our background. Simply click on OK, and you can see that file is created, and now it is showing selector, but we will change it to shape, and then here we will declare, I mean we will use gradient. So our start end color is color mid, and start color is color start, and then angle is 90, then close it. So you can see that this is our background file, and this is called gradient in Android Studio. So you can create it just by following these steps. Then you may be thinking that where is this color mid and color start. So let me show you that it is inside this color XML file. You can see that here I have already declared these colors. You can change these codes by your own if you want to make your UI more interactive, and you can improve it as much as you want. There is no limits. So after this, here I will give background, and it will be drawable background. Yeah guys, so let me close this background file, and also this main activity.java and login java, because we will not code java part in this video. So you can see that now this is our background file gradient, and but this action bar is looking too ugly. You can see that this is two different colors and it is not looking good. So how can we make it better is simply go to styles, and then here we have to declare a new style for our login activity. Simply write style, and we will give it name login, and then yeah, we will give it parent. Parent will be theme app compat light no action bar. So this will be our parent, and inside it we will use three items. So simply write item number one, and it is window action bar. So we will give it false, and item number 2, and it will be color primary dark. So here we will use the color mid because it is our color in upper side, so it will look good. Then after this I will write item, and item will be window no title. We will pass it, let me close it first, then true. So this is our style, and then after this you have to go to manifest file, and then here you can see that this is our login activity. So here we have to fix the theme. Simply write theme and we will give it style login. So after fixing the style, we will go to our XML file and see is it still the action bar is showing or not. So you can see that now the action bar is disappeared, and now our file, I mean UI, is looking more good. So here first of all we will use a simple text view, and inside this text view its width will be match parent, height will be wrap content, and the text will be login UI, and then text color is Android white, text size is 40 sp, and text alignment center, then close it. So after this we will use to edit text for email. So width will be 380 dp, and height will be wrap content, and hint will be user email, then ID will be login email, login underscore email, then hint color is Android white, text color, text size, I will not use text size, I will use text color, and it will be Android white, then background tint, it will be also white. So that line is now white, you can see. So after this, go in text view and give margin bottom 140 dp. So yeah, now it is looking good. You can decrease the size or increase the size, it depends on you how you want it to be look. So then simply close it. So now I think that we have given all important files. So yeah, simply copy this line, I mean copy this text view, and then simply paste it here. Yes, so after this, things we have to change is we will change the login email. So here we will write password, and inside email give input type email address, and inside password, sorry, input type text password. So it will just simply hide the password. So after this, give it some margin in the top, so 10 dp. This difference is good. So after this, here we will use a checkbox for showing the password, because when the user will check that checkbox, then you can easily see the password. And let me change its hint to password, and yeah, now it is fine. So after this, simply write checkbox, and its width will be 200 dp, and then we will give it height wrap content, and then text will be show password. Yes, show password. So button tint will be Android white, and text color will be also white. Yes, so now this is show password, and let me give it margin right 70 dp. Yes guys, so now it is in a perfect place. And then we will give it ID. So ID will be login checkbox. Yeah, now it is good. So after this, here we will use two buttons. So button number one, width will be 380 dp, and then its height will be the app content, and the background color will be Android white, text color will be Android red, and text will be login, and then margin top 20 dp. Yes guys, so now id will be login underscore button. So yes, now it is fine. So guys, after this simply copy this button, because we will need another button for our register activity. So change it to login, make it login underscore register button, so we can identify that it is for going on register activity. And then change its background color to, I will make it transparent white. So simply write hashtag then 30, it is for 30% white. Yes, you can see. And change text color to white, because now it is not visible. So write Android then color white. Now you can see that our button is looking quite good. And then after this, we have to change the text also. And text will be sign up. Yes, so user will understand that if you want to sign in, can one you want to create a new account, then you can go that in that activity. Then after this, we will here use a progress bar, and its width will be match parent, height will be wrap content, and id will be login underscore progress bar. And then after this, indeterminate tint, we will give it Android white, and then indeterminate we will pass it true. So what it will do is that, and then after this we will give it style, so style will be horizontal. So guys, what this indeterminate will do, that we will not see the exact progress, so it will just come and go, so it will appear like that. Then after this, visibility invisible, and then margin top 20 dp. So now you can see that our login UI is almost complete. So let me go to this design section, and yeah, now you can easily see. So let me give a little bit of margin in the top. So margin top in checkbox, make it 10 dp. Yes, now it is looking a little bit good. So now you can see that this is our progress bar, and two buttons to edit text, and one text view. So after this, simply what we have to do is create another activity for register. So simply go on Java and then click. So what here we have to do is that we have to create new. So simply click on new and then go to activity, and then choose MPD activity, and give it name register, and then simply click on finish. So now our activity is creating, as you can see on the screen. And so yeah guys, now our activity is complete. So simply close this register.java and go again in Android manifest XML file. So here we have to do the same process that we have given in login activity. So here we have to fix the theme again, and we will give style login. So then after fixing the style, you can see that we have given again the same style login that we have created. And then we will go to register activity, and you can see that again our action bar is disappeared, and our color is our mid color. So let me delete this XML file coding and then go to login XML file. And then here what we will do is simply copy this from here, and then go to register activity, and then simply paste it here. Yeah guys, that's all you have to do. And then we will change this context to register, because this is a register activity. And now we have to change the text. We have to make some little bit of changes, and after this we will change the ID. So it will be register email, and then here register password, and then here we have to use another edit text, I mean one more edit text for confirm password. So use it and then simply change the hint to confirm password. And yes, now after this, register underscore confirm password. Yes, now it is, I think, good. No more changes we have to make it in this. So after this, let me change this checkbox ID to register checkbox, and then register button, and this time we will change register underscore login button, and then after this again progress bar ID, so change it to register progress bar, register progress bar. So now guys, you can see that our register file, I mean register UI, is also complete. But let me change this text login UI. So make it create account, create account, and yes, and we have to change text in this buttons. So let me make it, oops, margin. Yes, it is without no mistake. So let me change this text to register, and its text to login. Yeah guys, now our UI files are almost complete, and you can see that this is our login underscore XML file, and it is also ready, and this is register XML file, and this is also ready. So if you like this video, then please like, share and subscribe my channel. Make sure you press the bell icon for future tutorials, because I will upload more interesting videos just like this. So thank you for watching.